then I'm willing to go with you. And when they got in the valley of Kedron, the river ran north, south. They got down to the banks of the river. The news got into the Caesareans, and as the Syrians heard the revolt, that there was a rebellion, the slaves were in an insurrection. They got the news from the throne room, and the King Jabin stood up, sent his best man of war, call in Sisera, who's been fighting from his youth. Bring in my 900 chariots of iron. Bring in the war stallions. Sisera said, yes, my lord. I can see Jabin, but all his intimidation, all his spirit of fear, rise up, he said, slay them, those little Israelitish dogs. How dare they buck up against me? How dare they insurrect against me? Sisera said, it's done before you can even take another breath. Walked out, put on his war helmet, put his cape on his shoulder, looked towards the east and the south, called his generals and his lieutenants, told them, ride, boys, we're going to lay the Israelites to rest. Got on their chariots, straddled side by side, iron wheel to iron wheel, three stallions black, driving one iron chariot, took three men on board to hold the chariot from bucking. Three men on board, three horses to pull the chariot, because it was iron. That's 2,700 horses, 2,700 men on board, riding side by side, 900 chariots of iron. The breast was 3 miles long. They were riding, going to come against Israel. They got on their chariots, looking towards the Kedron River. The Israelites could see them coming far off in a distance. They could hear the thunder of the stallions. They could feel the tremble of the iron chariot wheels. They could see the dust. They were coming in haste. They could see the cloud of dust in the atmosphere. Jabin's army was riding with the war Bangladesh. The flags were in the air. The trumpets sounding. War is coming. The worst trouble you've ever had is on the way. I could see Michael in the middle of the air. He said, shh, in the presence of the Lord. Said, Father, what will you have me to do? I see Deborah down in the valley. She's in the valley of the Kedrons. What do you want me to do? He said, wait a minute. Don't move. Deborah is a praying woman. When she looks towards the hill, from whence cometh her help, then I'll tell you what I want you to do. Deborah could see the enemy, but she was waiting on God. A praying person doesn't let trouble them until it's time to sound the alarm. She saw him riding. The lancemen were jostling right behind the chariot wheels. After that, you could see not only that, but you could see the archers began to put in their bows and began to shoot forth their arrows. Not only that, when they went forward, you could hear them scream and howl, and the lather from the stallions, who were used to smelling blood from war, were beginning to whinny in the air. When they got near the river, Deborah looked up towards the hill and said, oh Lord, send the help, send down the help. We need you, we need you. Somebody say yeah, somebody say yeah, say yeah, say yeah. Deborah cried out. Michael said, Lord, that's the sound. What will you have me to do? He said, now go to the north wind and the south wind, the west and the east wind. Tell them to meet you in the valley now. He said, is that all? He said, no. Stop by the galaxies. Line the heavens in order. Let every planetarium line up one behind the other. 5 and 20 said, the stars fought in their courses. They fought against Sisera while they were ready to come across the river. The stallions were jumping. The chariots were rocking. The enemies were ready. Michael left the presence of the Lord, got over to the east wind, north wind, west wind, south wind, said, meet me in the valley. Told the sun, now you back up. Told the moon, move a little to the right. Told Jupiter, Mars, and Venus, line up behind me. Called the Milky Way. Told the Milky Way, you get behind me. And Michael rolled the west wind into the valley of Kedron. Michael rolled in. God's children need it. He could hear the children saying, help us, help us, come in and get us. All of a sudden, physics rolled into action. Hot and cold can't stand together in the same place. Michael rode in the hot wind. The west wind kissed the north wind. Chill it back and step back. The east wind touched the north wind and could not stand and jump back. It started a tornado in the midst of the valley. All of a sudden, noonday turned into midnight. Sisera looked up and said, the gods are fighting against us. All of a sudden, it was midnight at noonday. Deborah said, he's here. God of glory is here. He's in the wind. He's in the stars. He's in the sun. Tell him yes. Say yes. Say yeah. Yeah. He'll fight for you. He'll fight for you. Mama may not fight, but God will fight. Your husband may not fight, but God will fight. Your best friend may walk out on you. Don't worry. Heaven will fight. Heaven will fight. You may be broke, but you're not busted. As long as God is God, heaven will fight. Heaven will fight. Tell him yeah. Tell him yeah. Tell him yeah. Tell him yeah. Yes, he will. You can't make me doubt him. I know too much about him. He saved me. He brought me. He turned me. He healed me. He kept me. Never left me. Heaven will fight. Heaven will fight for you. Put your hands together and give him the praise. Tell him yes. Tell him yes. Tell him yes. Tell him yes. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. Woo. Oh, hallelujah. Y'all have to forgive me. I'm so excited. So excited. So excited. Heaven will fight for you. Compared to this modern day society, you may look insignificant and like nothing. But when God said, heaven will fight, that means unconventional victory. Don't look for sword or shield. That means he's gonna come in and do the job himself. You say, Lord, but I've been having this problem so long till I don't even know how it would feel to be free. I've been